Hi everyone, I'm Megumi Kaneko from the National Institute of Informatics in Tokyo, Japan. And today is a great pleasure for me to give this preview talk for MobiCom 2020. So let me share my screen. So today I'll give a brief introduction to Massive MIMO technology. So first, let's review the general MIMO concept. So first, if we consider this point-to-point CISO system with one transmitter, one receiver, and one antenna each, and the link SNR gamma, the capacity is achieved by this well-known Shannon expression, so log base 2 of 1 plus SNR. Then, if we consider multiple antennas either at the transmitter or at the receiver, we get either a SAMO or MISO link. And in this case, the capacity can be improved as shown by this expression. So the SNR gamma is multiplied by the number of antennas M, and this is called the beamforming gain. And further, if we consider multiple antennas both at the transmitter side and the receiver side, so we get this point-to-point MIMO link. The theory tells that this initial CISO capacity is multiplied by this term called the multiplexing gain, which is the minimum between the transmit or receive antennas. And by considering multiple users, we obtain this multi-user MIMO system. And in particular, we can perform space division multiple access, or SDMA, whereby many parallel user transmissions can be separated in space. And such multi-user MIMO methods are used in current standards. However, in practice, the achieved performance is quite poor. And this is because the performance really requires accurate channel state information. And it also needs a very large overhead for channel state information acquisition. And it also requires quite complex signal processing. And this is why we have seen the advent of the massive MIMO technology. This idea was originated by this paper by Professor Thomas Marzetta. So here are the main characteristics of massive MIMO systems. So we have one base station with many antennas M, and also multiple users. So massive MIMO systems are intrinsically multi-user MIMO systems. However, we have much more base station antennas M than the number of users K. And actually each user may carry only one single antenna. And this enables a very high spectral efficiency. Therefore, we can have much more spatially multiplexed users through SDMA as compared to classical MIMO. And we also have more directive and narrower beams. And this therefore entails less interference leakage among the different users. And here are a few asymptotical motivations to have massive MIMO. So let's consider this very simple system with one base station with M antennas and two users with channel vector H1 to user 1 and channel vector H2 to user 2. So the first remarkable property is called channel hardening, and it is expressed through this equation. So this means that the channel power towards each user divided by the number of base station antennas M tends towards a constant as M grows. And this means that the small scale channel variations will reduce with M. And also it means that the channel power will scale with M. And hence this means that a higher link reliability can be achieved with a larger number of antennas. And the second property is called the favorable propagation as expressed here. And this means that the m-dimensional channels H1 and H2 will become asymptotically orthogonal. And therefore, the base station will be able to more easily separate these users as the number of antennas grow. Another property that is worth mentioning is that simple linear processing such as zero forcing or maximum ratio combining, will be near optimal under large M. However, as for MIMO technology, also in massive MIMO, we will need an accurate knowledge of channel state information at the base station. And this will be really crucial to perform this accurate beamforming. And in massive MIMO, this CSI will be acquired through this uplink channel estimation. So here, each user sends its own pilot signals to the base station. And based on these pilots, the base station will estimate each channel. And therefore, we will need orthogonal pilot signals within each cell in order to accurately estimate the channel state of each user. And this means that the pilot sequence lengths should be larger than the number of users K in each cell. However, there are two major drawbacks in massive MIMO. So the first one is that it only works in general in time division duplexing, or TDD. And this is under this uplink downlink channel reciprocity. Therefore, in general, a massive MIMO will not be available for frequency division duplexing. But the second drawback is that we will see increased inter-cell interference due to the pilot contamination. So what is this pilot contamination? So here, due to the limited amount of radio resources, the different pilots need to be reused among different cells. So this means that users who are located in those cells will have to send the same pilot sequences as shown in this figure. And in massive MIMO, so we have two types of inter-cell interference. First one is the coherent interference, and this scales with the number of base station antennas M, and it is generated from those pilot sharing users. The other type is called the non-coherent interference, and this one is independent of M, and this arises from all the users within the system. Then this pilot contamination will have two major effects. Firstly, it will decrease the quality of the channel estimates at the base station. And secondly, it will give rise to this coherent interference. And therefore, pilot contamination will impose some capacity limitation, and we cannot get rid of this limitation even for under large M. To mitigate this effect, we can have higher reuse factors among these cells that reuse those pilots. And this will mitigate this coherent interference. However, it will also decrease the achievable rate of the system because we'll need to spend more radio resources in order to accommodate these increased amounts of pilot sequences. Therefore, we will need a good trade-off in order to fix this reuse, in order to fix the appropriate reuse factor. And this trade-off will depend on the environment, the number of users, but also the user mobility profiles. So next, I will say just a few words on massive MIMO in millimeter wave bands, because there are some related papers on this topic. So given the severe spectrum crunch in the current wireless systems, the use of millimeter wave bands will become necessary in order to support beyond 5G and 6G applications. However, the millimeter wave frequencies are known to be very vulnerable to obstacles, and they undergo also a very high pass loss. Therefore, very highly directive pencil beams will become necessary. And such beams are enabled through massive MIMO. So we can say that massive MIMO can enable can guarantee high communication quality in these high frequency bands. Another point is that in millimeter wave frequencies, the wavelengths are much shorter than that for sub-6 gigahertz frequencies. So this means that more antenna elements can be packed within a given area, because we need to guarantee space of a separation of lambda over two between different antenna elements. So this becomes easier under millimeter waves. And there are different ways of implementing massive MIMO in millimeter wave bands. So the first one is called digital beamforming. And this requires one RF chain, a radio frequency chain, per antenna element, as shown here. However, this is very costly and power consuming, especially for large M and in millimeter waves. So we also have so-called analog beamforming. And here we only need one RF chain for all antenna elements. And instead we have phase shifters that control each, that is one phase shifter attached to each antenna element. And these phase shifters will control the beams directly in the RF domain. So this guarantees a low cost. However, we can only form a single stream transmission. So STMA will not be available under this architecture. And between these two extremes, we find the hybrid beamforming. And this enables a trade-off between the analog and digital beamforming. So here we use a few, but still multiple RF chains. So this can guarantee STMA while spending only lower costs as compared to digital beamforming. So here's a list of related papers in MobiCom 2020. So unfortunately, I didn't have access to the full paper versions of these accepted papers. So I don't know how much this presentation will be useful. However, I hope that I have been able to convey at least the main ideas and the main issues pertaining to massive MIMO. And finally, of course, there are many references on MIMO and massive MIMO. But here are some books and also some slides and video presentations that I can recommend to understand further these topics. So thank you very much for your attention. And I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference. Bye-bye.